गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल बी टेलिंग यू अबाउट द लेजेंड ऑफ द नॉर्थ आइलैंड. सो लेट मी रिवाइज द न्यू ऑल द इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स बिफोर मूविंग टू द लास्ट सेकेंड टू स्टैंडेस्टर इट वॉज लेफ्ट टू बी एक्सप्लेन. सो चिल्ड्रन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट इज रिटन बाई कोपी कैरी हु वॉज बॉर्न ऑन सेप्टेम्बर 1824. ओके, एंड शी वॉज एन अमेरिकन पोएटिस. And the younger sister was Alice Carey. So both the sisters, they used to write the poem. They have children, their sisters who published poem in 1849. And then each went to publish volume of their own. So these two sisters were very talented, capable of writing some good poems. They have presented to the world also. Okay. What is the central idea, first of all, this poem? What they wanted to tell in this poem, Kopi Kari? The poem puts forth the idea that we should not be selfish and always help the needy. So the main thing she wanted to say that we should not be selfish, we should always help the needy person. A selfish person has no satisfaction in life. So whoever will be selfish, children, they will never have any satisfaction in life. Now children, what she wanted to tell you is a theme of the poem. So the theme of the poem is that children, she is starting the poem with the Northland. So Northland is the coldest land in the whole earth. It is near the polar region. Okay, and it is every time it is generally it is covered with snow. So children, since it is near polar, not pole, so the weather is always cold here. So cold weather will always be is the main feature of this land. They get very few minutes or hours of sunlight. Now children, since the winter is there, so the hours of day are very less and the nights are very long. The people are not able to spend their good night sleeping. Now children, the poetess here, she is not sure about the authenticity of the story, but then she wanted to share one of the story of Northland. So let me tell you what was that story in short. So Saint Peter, he was the messenger, he is the messenger of God, okay, and he was on his usual round of traveling and preaching people. He felt hungry. He chanced upon an old cottage where a little woman was making cakes. Saint Peter went near the woman and asked for some cakes to eat. The little woman started to bake a small cake for him. After the cake was done, she found it too big to be given for free. So she decided to bake an even smaller cake. This went on and on till then she made a very thin cake which is known as wafer for Saint Peter. And children, when it was the time to give that wafer to Saint Peter, she did not give it. Then also she felt greedy. She even kept that wafer with herself instead of giving it to Saint Peter, because she was so greedy to part with a single morsel of food, and she was thinking that she would get money if she will sell that also. So on observing our children, Saint Peter was waiting outside the house and he was feeling a little, he was about to faint because of tiredness and was very much hungry. So he was about to faint. And children, he observed her need. When Saint Peter waited and waited, and then he came to him, he observed her greed. Then he became very angry at her. He said that she was too selfish to dwell in human form, and he had cursed her to become a bird and leave searching for scanty food in the jungle by digging all dry and hard roots. Now children, after Saint Peter cursed the little woman, immediately she changed into the bird and she went up to the chimney and turned into a woodpecker. So she was turned into a woodpecker, and since she went up to the chimney, her whole body turned to coal black because of growing up to of the woodpecker. She was putting red cap, which has turned to be the scarlet of the woodpecker. After that, people see her in the forest where she lives by boring and boring and dry wood in search of food. So children, after that, all the boys who used to go and return back to the school, and many people who used to come to the ways, what they have seen her, that a woodpecker is there, and she had seen boring and boring the food in such thing. So, but let me revise once again the children main points of the poem. The Northland is a cold region. Okay, there the nights are longer as compared to days in winter. One Saint Peter stopped at an old lady cottage because he was feeling very hungry. The lady was baking cakes on the hearth. Okay, she was baking cake on the hearth when Saint Peter asked for few cakes because he was very hungry and tired also. She tried to make tiny cakes. She tried to make a small cake, but she could not part even with that big cake, for she found it too large to give it to him. She thought she can earn more money if she will sell those cakes. Now, finally, children, she made a very small thin wafers, and that also she did not give him to eat him. Now, when Saint Peter saw her greed, he was very angry. He cursed her, saying that she was far too selfish to be human, to have food, shelter, and fire to keep her warm. Thus, she was transformed into a woodpecker. All her clothes except her scarlet cap were gone as she went up the chimney and flew out of the top. Every schoolboy is said to have seen her in the forest pouring into the wood for food. Now, away and away in the Northland, where the hours of the day are few. So children, here the poet has started writing the poem. Children, he has started with the children with the cold region. He started this with saying that a Northland was there. So children, Northland is what? Northland is a cold land near the polar region. And there, children, the weather is very, what to say, it's very cold throughout the year. The snow is there. Okay, very few hours they get for a sunlight. So this was the situation, and all worst thing was that it was winter time, so everything was covered with snow. So children, this whole thing we have discussed with you, except the last two paragraph in my previous video I could not discuss. Okay, the last two paragraphs are paragraph 15, 14, 15 and 16, last three paragraphs. So children, he cursed her when he did not get food. He cursed her. Then I am going to read 14 and 15, and then I will be explaining to 16. 14 is, then up she went through the chimney, never speaking a word, and out of the top flew a woodpecker, for she was changed into a bird. Now children, when Saint Peter did not get food, though he never used to do anything, but that day he was so annoyed, he was so tired, he was about to faint. So when he observed her, when he saw her, then he saw that she was in a no mood of giving him any food, and she was just sitting inside. Even she did not even came and told him that we could not serve you any food. So this made him very angry, and children, he had cursed her. Okay, and children, due to his curse, she has changed into a bird, and which bird? Woodpecker. So in the fourth stanza, the 14th stanza, that bird, now she is moving through the chimney. Now she is, since she is a bird, she cannot leave inside the house. She has to leave the house. And children, there is a chimney, and she is going up through the chimney, never speaking a word. Children, even she was drumstruck, she was even shocked. Okay, she never spoke a word. And out of the top flew a woodpecker. And children, what happened? Out of the top flew a woodpecker. At the top, a woodpecker was there, for she was changed to bird. And that woodpecker was changed into a children bird. Now, she had a scarlet cap on her head, and that was left the same. But all the rest of her clothes were burned, black as a coal in the flame. So scarlet is bright red, and same is exactly like flame is fire. So she had a scarlet cap on her head. So scarlet cap. So she was having a scarlet cap. Scarlet is a bright red color. Cylind, which has changed to the which has changed, children. You can see, children, in the woodpecker, something red is there over their head. Something reddish, maroonish red is there. So that was in fact the scarlet which that woman was wearing. Okay, and same is exactly like flame is fire. So children, she had a scarlet cap on her hand, and which was changed into a reddish color of the bird. And her cold wear, children, her clothes were like the poles, because when she was flying from the chimney, her whole body had a suit on her body. What was left out when the lady changed into it? When she, the scarlet cape was left as it when she changed into a bird, and her whole body became like a pole. And every country schoolboy has seen her in the wood where she lives in the tree till this very day, bringing and pouring the food. And every country schoolboy, okay, every country schoolboy had seen her in the wood where she lived in the trees till this very day, pouring and pouring for food. So children, she was pouring and pouring for, she was, and every now children, she has seen it to a bird. She had seen pouring and pouring, pouring and pouring, pouring means children taking her long peek into the wood to find the food. So she was doing that only. Okay, everybody, not only the schoolboy but many people in the wood have seen her doing the same thing. She is trying to find food by pouring and pouring her long peak. And now at present, that lady, she was seen into a bird. She is living in a tree, and she gets her food with a great difficulty by pouring. She gets the food. Every schoolboy has seen her in the wood. Her own nature of selfishness was the reason for her condition. Okay. Her own nature of selfishness was the reason for this condition. Even if she would have given that small bread to St. Peter, this situation should not have arisen from him. Now, some important question answer. So children, which country or country, let me discuss a textual question first. Which country or countries do you think the northern refers to? So it is the country in the north where days are short and nights are long. What did St. Peter ask the old lady for? St. Peter asked the old lady for a piece of cake. The lady behaved miserly and kept increasing the size of the cake. At last, she did not give St. Peter anything to eat. How did he punish her? He cursed her and made her a woodpecker. How does the woodpecker get her food? The woodpecker holds the hard and dry wood to get its food. Do you think that the old lady would have been so ungenerous if she had not known who St. Peter really was? What would she have done? No, she would not have done that if she would have known that he was the person who sent Peter. On the contrary, she would have given him a large piece of cake to make him happy with a grin, to get a handsome return. Is this a true story? Which part of the poem do you think is the most important? No, it's an imaginary story. It is a legend. The third stanza of the poem is very important. What is a legend? Why this poem is called a legend? A legend is a story from ancient time about people and events. The title of the poem tells us that it is a legend. The poet himself says that I don't believe it is a truth. Now some additional questions, children, which is very important. Okay. So why was St. Peter tired and hungry? So Saint Peter was tired and hungry because he was a holy man. He used to teach people. For his preaching, he often made long journey. During the course of his journey, sometimes he did not take food and water. Besides, he had to observe fast also. Fast and journey were the essential part of his life. Hence, he was tired and hungry. So, children, you can see that why Saint Peter, he was so tired and he was hungry, because he had to do so many journeys to feed the people. He was a messenger of God. What happened to the thief every time when the old lady tried to meet with? The old lady was a greedy woman. She had no desire to share her things with others. Once Saint Peter was tired and hungry, he arrived at her cottage to get something to eat. The old lady tried again and again to make a too small cake for Saint Peter, but the size of cake always appeared to her bigger, and the lady was even unable to give this cake to the saint. What happened to the old lady when Saint Peter cursed her? Saint Peter became angry at her greed because she did not give a piece of cake to Saint Peter to satiate his hunger. When he cursed the lady, she turned into a bird. She flew to the chimney. Finally, she became a woodpecker. She wore a red cape and her body was flat. Besides, she was bound to live in the forest with scanty food. Describe the landscape of the Northland as described in the poem. So, the landscape is far away in the north. In this land of snow and ice, the days are very short. The nights are too long. When it snows, they harness swift reindeer to the sledge. Children are packed with many layers of clothes to protect them from the cold. In their funny and furry clothes, they all look bear cubs, that means the small babies of the bear, and they look very funny. Why does the poet tell a story which he does not believe to be true? The poet tells the story which he did not believe to be true. The poet wants to tell a curious story. It is the story of a Saint Peter and greedy little woman. The poet himself doesn't believe that the story is true, but still he is compelled to tell the story because the story has a nice moral in it. The story gives a moral lesson that greed is an evil trait in man. It is punished in the end. The greedy little woman who did not want to give a small piece of cake to Saint Peter, who was so hungry, and he came to her door. Generally, children, people, every time people used to give him that, but even he had asked from that lady, just because of greed, she could not share the cake to him. So Saint Peter cursed her, and she became a woodpecker. Whole life she had to live with little food. We should show human qualities in our behavior. So children, we should never be mean. We should always help others. If children, anybody required help, we should always help others. Why did the then who was Saint Peter, and why did he go to the cottage of a little girl? So Saint Peter, we all know he's a holy man, he's a messenger of God, and he's a Christian saint. He went around different places preaching the people. Too much traveling made him tired and hungry. He needed food and rest badly. Therefore, he went to the cottage of a little woman who was making cakes. He asked the woman to give one from her store of cakes to him. Question number 7. Why did the little woman need another and still a smaller cake? So Saint Peter asked the little woman to give one cake from her store of cake. The little woman made a very little piece of cake to give it to the hungry saint. Every time she was baking the cake, she was keeping to herself by feeling that if she will sell that cake, she would get money. So she should make one smaller cake. Then again she went and made a smaller cake. And finally she made a wafer. For that also she could not give to Saint Peter. Therefore, children, the greedy little woman needed another and still a smaller cake, but then also she could not share that cake with Saint Peter. Well, why did the little old woman have to struggle for her scanty food after she was cursed to be a woodpecker? So why she has to search for the food which was very scanty in the wood? Scanty means very less. The greedy little woman denied hungry St. Peter even a small piece of cake. She made a very small piece of cake, but it seemed too large to her to be given away. She went on making it still smaller and smaller. She was cursed by St. Peter to be a woodpecker. She was made to struggle even for her scanty food. As a woodpecker, she went on boring to get a small morsel of food. What quality do you find in saints? Saints are wise people. They have great heavenly powers. They are the messengers of God. Riches make no sense for them, for which people often children. They starve to be rich. They wanted to be rich. They need only food to survive this world. They travel far off land and give people moral lesson. Now children, I will be discussing some long portions with you. Now, so my first question is, a holy man should not curse the lady. Justify the statement in the context of the poem A Legend of the North. Children, generally holy men, they doesn't curse anyone, and especially to a lady they never curse. So but here such a pious person like St. Peter, who never used to be angry, he has cursed that lady. So you have to justify the statement. A holy man is known for his wisdom. He teaches moral lesson to the people. Whether they are laborer or greedy, all are equal in his eyes. In the present story, St. Peter is a holy man. He is also famous for his preaching. He has preached and traveled a lot. So he is hungry. He asks the lady for some food, but she does not share her food with him. Finally, the saint becomes angry and curses her in fact. He should have shown some mercy and the example of his wisdom. Therefore, it is appropriate to say that a holy man should not curse a lady. Now, my second question, long question is, how can you say that the old lady was greedy? Definitely, children, she was very much greedy. This we have realized. So, the old lady was running a bakery. She used to bake a cake. St. Peter was a wise saint. He had traveled and preached a lot, so he was very much exhausted or very tired, and he was hungry. He had arrived at her door of her house, and he told her that he is very hungry and he wanted something. Still, the lady made him wait for the cake for a long time. And finally, children, she tried to bake two small cakes, but unfortunately, that cake often seemed to her a bigger size. The old lady did not want to share that cake also with the saint. At last, you know, St. Peter grew so angry that he had cursed her. So it can be said that her greed had no limit. Now, why was St. Peter forced to curse the greedy little woman? Do you justify the action of St. Peter? St. Peter was a holy man. He was a Christian saint. He spent his time moving around places and preaching the people there. Saints generally bless the people. They don't curse them. However, these holy men resort to cursing when people defy good senses and become evil. The little woman in the story was extremely selfish and greedy. After much traveling and preaching, St. Peter had become tired. He had become weak and hungry. After the fast, he came to the cottage of the little woman for food. Seeing her baking cake, St. Peter asked her to give one from her store of cake. The greedy woman made a very little piece of cake for him. Even that small piece looked too large to be given away to the saint. Hence, she went on making it smaller and smaller. The hungry St. Peter cursed the selfish and greedy woman. She was cursed to be a woodpecker and boring. She started struggling with her life. And children, she started struggling for her food, scanty food, which was now written in her pain. St. Peter was justified in cursing her. She had deprived a tired and hungry saint even from a small piece of cake. she was rightly punished for her good. Even children, even she did not want to, if she would not, did not want to give that cake to her, she would have come and told that I did not want to give any cake to you. Instead, children, she was sitting quietly in her house. Children, the saint was almost, he was about to faint, and he became so angry that he cursed her. And in this manner, I feel that this was justified. His angriness, we can say, is justified. Why was the little woman cursed particularly to be a woodpecker and not another bird? It's a very interesting question, children. How did she struggle to get her scanty food? The little woman aroused the anger of a holy man. The Saint Peter spent most of his time in traveling and preaching. Constant fasting had made him hungry and weak. Saint Peter asked for a small piece of cake. Then he saw a little woman baking cake. The greedy woman could have easily given a piece of cake to the saint, but the selfish woman thought that even a very little piece was too large to be given to him. She denied even this little offering. The saint cursed her to be a woodpecker. A woodpecker has to bore for a long time to get even a scanty food. She was cursed to labor hard by boring into the tree to get even her scanty food. As she had made the saint waited so long for such a small piece of cake and gave nothing. What moral lesson do you get from this poem, student? I think I've already told many times. So the poem teaches us that true happiness lying in sharing the thing. We must not be mean. We should always try to help others. Okay. We should always be content. We should be satisfied in life, in our life, whatever the God has given us. We should be satisfied. We should help the person, okay, whenever in the time of need. If we are greedy, we cannot have happiness in our life like that lady. On the other hand, our charitable nature makes us think about pains and sorrows suffered by the other people. The charitable people have many friends, and they are always connected with one another with a strong bond of friendship, sentiments, friendship and sentiments. But the greedy people have hardly any friends, and they often live alone in the world. So, how is true satisfaction spoiled by greed? This is a moral value-based question. True satisfaction lies in sharing things with others. Peace and satisfaction are the two sides of a coin. If there is a satisfaction in our life, peace is bound to come in our life. However, greed spoils both. If we are greedy, we cannot get satisfaction as well as peace in our life. In the poem, the old lady was greedy and she failed to give cake to the saint. If she had satisfaction, she would certainly have shown honor and regard to the saint. So in the case of this little lady, it can be said that her greed had spoiled her peace and satisfaction. Actually, saints try to create such societies in which all the people shall be treated with equality and greed will have no room in them. With the help of teaching, they desire to bring down heavens on the earth. So children, you can see that how that lady greed has not only spoiled her life, but throughout her life she became the sufferer. So children, the moral of the story is that we should never be greedy. Whatever God has given us, we should try to help the other. And you can see how, children, that satisfaction is much greater than the satisfaction which you are having if you are having money or power. We should try to understand the problem of other. Saint Peter, he was a saint. Okay. So she, in fact, she was not knowing. Otherwise, I think she would have given. But then, children, this represents the greedy nature. In the form of that woman, the poet wanted to tell about all the greedy people. They should stop their greediness. Okay. Instead, they should help others at least at the time of their need. If they will not help others, children, then they will be the sufferer. one day they will come, even if they will need help, nobody will be helping them. So with this, children, I end my poem here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. Good morning, students, children. How are you? Today I will be revising with you a new lesson. Okay. The name of the lesson is A Legend of the Northland. I've done some parts in my previous video, and today we will finish this poem. Okay.